Production at Boeing's Washington State plant has essentially come to a halt as the union and the aircraft manufacturer try to reach a deal that would bring 33,000 workers back on the job. Karen Kafa has the latest on the strike.
Federal mediators working to bring Boeing and the union representing 33,000 of its workers closer together.
If you want to attract talented people here, you have to give them a decent pay raise.
Late last week, members of the International Association of Machinists and Aerospace Workers Union rejected a deal reached between union leaders and Boeing and walked off the job.
Give me back my retirement, give me my decent pay raise, and you'll have 33,000 people actually willing to help you build airplanes.
Since 2018, a series of crashes and near disasters have dented Boeing's finances and reputation. But last year, Boeing's then CEO saw a 45% pay raise, while wages of Boeing's union workers stayed flat. Art Wheaton of the Cornell University School of Industrial and Labor Relations says the workers have leverage because their work is so specialized.
It is a huge problem trying to replace those workers because there's not a lot of people that know how to build airplanes, especially these large airplanes around the world. There's a very limited skill set for this.
In a Monday employee memo, Boeing announced temporary spending cuts, including a hiring freeze and travel restrictions, and said furloughs of employees and executives are possible.
A strike can cost them more than $1 billion a week, so they really do need to get this solved quickly.
Union members say they want a 40% pay bump over 4 years to make up for recent inflation and for nearly two decades of past contracts that downsized retirement and health care benefits. In Washington, I'm Karen Kafa.